you don't peak too early. Thank you, Ben. What a thrill to be here amongst my own kind. Because I'm very left-wing as well, you know. I mean, I've frightened myself how left-wing I am. If I wasn't a camp comic and renowned homosexual, I would grow a beard and wear corduroy. That's how left-wing I am. Are you wearing a mustard top? What were you thinking of? Where are you from?
Bedfordshire.
Bedfordshire?
Yeah.
Oh. What day's the market there? Clearly you have one. No, the thing is, if you'd mentioned homosexuality 40 years ago, you'd have had some very old-fashioned looks, but nowadays we've come a long way. I mean, did you know it is now a colour shade at Farrow and Ball? I recently tried homosexual... can't say the word. I tried homosexuality in the downstairs toilet. I feel I ruined that joke. I blame myself. But the relief to be here in a shiny studio out of in London after the shitholes I've been playing up recently. I was in Eastbourne last night. Have you been there? I mean, fuck me, Pink. It was like doing a show in the waiting room at Dignitas. I had to self-medicate in the interval to bring myself down to their level. Had so many cocodamol, I was halfway between being unable to operate heavy machinery and a coma. Any of my jokes you don't understand, you just stick your hand up. In the air. But I want to cheer you up. I'm not here. I'm not going to talk about Liz Truss, for goodness sake. I've had erections lasted longer than she did. Let's talk about something cheery. Do you remember when we could afford to go on holiday? Fancy wearing a hoodie at your age. I once went on a gay cruise, which I don't recommend. There were so many gay men on board. At one point, I thought, well, we're going to get blown off course. But I like to go on holiday with my husband. Yes, I am married. I married an Australian called Rolf, but you're not to worry. He is an Australian, he is called Rolf. I met him in Sydney. I was swimming off Bondi Beach and I didn't realise 20 foot below me was the Sydney Gay Subaqua Group. Next thing I knew, I'd been sucked under. And I came to in the arms of a gorgeous lifeguard called Rolf and I married him. It's a true story, as true as I'm riding this bicycle. Anyway, we went on holiday and we went to a beautiful resort in the middle of the Indian Ocean, a little island, which I won't bother telling you what it's called because it's of no use to you. It's exclusive to celebrities. No, they're very strict about it. As soon as you arrive on the jetty, you're given a questionnaire. Have you sat in the front row of a London fashion show? Have you had a centre spread in Hello magazine? Have you had a short but meaningless affair with Ulrika Johnson? If you answer no to any of these questions, you're not allowed on the island. Stephen Mulhern was turned away. With all his talent. But once you're on that island, it's absolutely lovely. Everyone is as celeb as I say, even the staff. Dame Helen Mirren was our chambermaid. Princess Michael of Kent was in charge of nibbles at the bar. And our waiter at the Moonlit Terrace restaurant was Rylan, who I absolutely love. And he took our order. I said, I'll have the sea bream. He said, would you like that filleted? I thought, this is my kind of holiday. Well, we were just tucking into our starters. Who should wander up but Holly Willoughby in a sarong? There was a queue, but she skipped that. As she was chatting, she lowered her breasts into my husband's soft-shell crab. Then she moved on. Well, a couple of seconds later, a member of a well-known boy band minced over. And as he was chatting, he undid his flies and just slid his penis into my vichyssoise. I called Rylan over. I said, waiter, there's a McFly in my soup. Oh. so much. I have to now go and slip into something more comfortable, like a taxi. Thank you very much.